Now that we have some intuition for the Turing machine, we turn to the task of establishing some notation for our mathematical model. Here I've used a diagram to represent the Turing machine and its configuration. We have the tape, the read-write head, which is connected to the state transition logic, and a little display here that will indicate the halt state, that is, the internal state of the Turing machine when it stops. Mathematically, a Turing machine consists of a finite set of states Q. Everything used to specify a Turing machine is finite, by the way. That's critically important. Next, we need to specify an input alphabet of allowed symbols. This must not include the blank symbol, which we will notate with this square cut most of the time. For some of the quizzes where we need you to be able to type the character, we will use B. We can't allow the input alphabet to include the blank symbol, or we wouldn't be able to tell where the input string ended. The whole rest of the tape, where the input string is not written, by the way, has blanks on it. We also define the tape alphabet of symbols, and that's the set of symbols that the read-write head can use. And this will include the blank symbol. A Turing machine also specifies a transition function from a state tape symbol pair to a state tape symbol direction triple. This, of course, tells the machine what to do. For every possible current state and symbol that could be read, we have the appropriate response. The new state to move to, the symbol to write to the tape, you can make this the same as the input one to leave the tape alone, and the direction to move the head relative to the tape. Note that we can always move the head to the right, but if the head is currently over the first position of the tape, then we can't actually move left. When the transition function says that the machine should move the head left, then we just have it stay in the same position by convention. A Turing machine also specifies a start state. The machine always starts in the first position on the tape and in this state. And finally, we have an accept and a reject state. When these are reached, the machine halts its execution and displays the final state. At first, all this notation may seem overwhelming. It is a 7-tuple, after all. Remember, however, that all the machine ever does is respond to the current symbol it sees based on its current state. Thus, it's the transition function that is at the heart of the machine, and most all of the important information, like the set of states and the tape alphabet, is implicit in it.